In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create this pretty cool freeze frame effect inside Adobe After Effects. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Here we go!
So to get started, I'm inside Adobe After Effects. I already have my clip inside a composition. And the first thing that we want to do is with our clip, we want to go forward to this point in time at which we want to freeze frame it. So probably right around here, right before he releases the basketball, right around there is good. So once you find the moment in time that you'd like to freeze frame your video clip, the next step is to add a marker. That way we know the exact moment in time that we want the clip to be frozen at. So to do that, I'm going to hit Shift 8 to add a marker. The next step is to duplicate our clip. So I'm going to click on our clip, hit Command D to duplicate it once. And on this top layer, what we're going to do is mask him out. And to do that, I'm going to use the pen tool. So grab the pen tool. You can start making points and cutting around your subject here. I'm going to zoom in quite a bit. So I'm going to grab my zoom tool and just make a selection around the top part and then grab the pen tool and then just start creating your mask. This will take some time, so to speed up this tutorial a little bit, I will speed it up to the end of the masking. But just a few tips here, you can click and drag to kind of make more curved points around your subject. And if you're zoomed in to navigate further down on your subject, you can switch to the hand tool by clicking H, and then just click and drag down, and then switch back to your pen tool by clicking G once again, and then continue drawing your mask. All right, so I'm gonna speed this up and we'll get to the end of the masking here. All right, so I'm gonna close it off by clicking on the first point once again. If you need to make adjustments, you can always click and drag on your points to fine tune it. But once you have your mask down, the next step is we're gonna zoom out. So I'm gonna fit my scale to view here. You'll see that we have our mask around our completed subject. The next part is to freeze frame it. So to freeze frame a clip inside After Effects, you'll just wanna right click on the layer and then go to time, freeze frame. And if we scrub this back, you can see that we have our frozen clip here. So the other thing to do is to trim this layer. So I'm going to click on it. I'm going to do the keyboard shortcut Option N bracket to trim my layer. You can also just click and drag the edge. Just make sure that the layer ends right at that point. That way, once it continues past that point, the freeze frame disappears. So it looks like the basketball player is going up to that point, and then it kind of just disappears right after that. All right, so the final step here is to motion track our clip and then to realign the freeze frame. That way it looks like it's moving with the camera. So you'll notice that the camera pans from left to right, and we'll have to just match the freeze frame to that motion. So to do that, what we're going to do is click on our original clip down below. We're going to make a new null object. So we're going to go to layer, new, null object. We'll use this for tracking purposes. But with the bottom clip selected, we're going to navigate to our tracker window. If you don't see it, you can go up to window tracker. Should be in the right hand side typically. We can click on track motion. This will open up the layer source panel here. You'll see that we have a tracker point here in the center. We can just expand the search area quite a bit here and the inner rectangle and then find a good tracking point. And for this, you really want to find something that's always in the frame that is consistent with the movement. For example, in this clip, the basketball lines on the court are a good indicator. So if we click and drag this down, we can kind of find a nice spot. Maybe right here in this intersection of the different lines. That way After Effects has a good solid base to track the footage with. Once you find a good spot and you adjust your points, the next thing that you can do is track backwards. So we're gonna click this Analyze Backwards button because keep in mind we're at this moment here, we wanna analyze backwards, so we're backtracking the motion essentially. So we're gonna click the back button and we're gonna let After Effects do its thing and it's analyzing backwards. All right, so once it's done, it should look something like this. You should see a motion path inside your layer panel here. And the next step is to edit your target. So I'm gonna click on this button here. Just make sure that the null object is selected because we want to apply the tracking information to that. And we're essentially gonna parent pick whip the still frame to the null object. So with that selected, click OK, and then click Apply. And then just make sure this says X and Y and click OK. Now, if we click on the null object and we click U on our keyboard, you can see that the position is keyframed. So essentially we have this animated null object that we can parent things to. So this is a helpful tip. If we go to the last keyframe here, what we can do is then click on our freeze frame clip in our timeline, and then under parent and link, we can link it to the null object. And now when we click and scrub this back and we play it back, you can see that we have this pretty cool effect inside After Effects. Now, when you play it back, you might notice that you have to fine tune the mask a little bit. You know, you can see the outline a little bit in the player. For this, if I go back to the clip, I can easily just click MM to bring up the masking options. I can maybe bring in the mask expansion a little bit, maybe by 2 pixels, and that should pretty much do it. Can even maybe add a little bit of feather, maybe by 3 pixels. That way it's a little bit softer and it blends a little bit better with the underneath video clip. But something like that will smooth it out a little bit. And here's the final result. So that's how you can create that pretty cool effect inside After Effects. If you want to learn more about After Effects, there's several tutorials on my channel. I'll link one that you might like right up there. Feel free to go watch that. But otherwise, I hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you guys next time. Take care.